गुड मॉर्निंग डियर चिल्ड्रन, दिस इज श्रुति मैम, मॉडर्न इंग्लिश स्कूल, न्यू एरिया, नवादा। टुडे वी विल लर्न द पोएम रेन ऑन द रूफ बाय कोट्स किनी। रेन ऑन द रूफ, हियर बाय एनालाइजिंग द टाइटल ऑफ द पोएम, द नेम ऑफ द पोएम, वी आर गेटिंग थ्री वर्ड्स, द रेन ऑन द रूफ। रूफ मीन्स दैट ऑन द टॉपमोस्ट फ्लोर। So that here in this poem, the poet is describing his feeling when he was experiencing a night when it was raining. The poet was in his cottage and on his bed. It was a starry night, means the sky was clear and all over the night stars were there. But when the humid hovers, means that humidity was humid clouds, that black clouds, humid clouds was spread the whole sky, the starry sky, it was dark, and soon it started raining. And that every raindrops that were falling on the roof, and the poet was able to hear the sounds of the raindrops, and it seems that the sky was sad and the sky started weeping, and the poet was expressing his own feeling that it was a bliss, it was a blessing to listen, to hear the sounds of the rains. In the second stanza, this poem is having three stanzas, and each stanza is having eight lines, and the rhyming pattern is A B C, B C D and F E. In the second stanza, that when that somebody is alone and it is night and the raindrops are falling, rain is falling, so naturally after some time that lots of memories will come in somebody's mind. Same thing happened to the poem. So that memories were coming, and that memories obviously it were of past memories, and thousands of thousands memories were coming, thousands of thousands dreams were coming, and that the all were of past memories. Third stanza, that the raindrops are falling on the roof, that every single drops of rain were echoing in the heart of the poet. That means that poet was able to listen the sounds of the raindrops, each and every raindrops, and each and every raindrops were, that the sound of the each and every raindrops were spreading in the heart as well as in the mind. And what was the effect? That then that thousands of memories, thousands of recollections, thousands of dreams, they were started coming into the poet's mind, and all the memories and all the dreams were of past. Third stanza, this is the summary of the second stanza. In the third stanza, in the second stanza, the poet told that the memories were coming in his mind. So in the third stanza, what he was telling? He was telling that now that at last that memories were coming, the memories which were of his mother's memory, who is no more, means now that mother is not alive. And that in his childhood, that how his mother was loving him, how mother loved him, and the whole day how his mother loved him, how his mother cared him, and at night how she was looking at him fondly, nicely, lovingly, and that till night she wishes that the poet will get nice dreams. And that all the activities, all the movements, all the gestures just were coming into the poet's mind. So this is the poem that Rain on the Roof. This is the poem that which tells us that when somebody is lonely, and what happens in a rainy night, that what happens when the raindrops fall around us and especially on the roof, and when somebody is lonely. And that yes, if somebody is lonely means his or her mind is not busy. So naturally, that by the sound of the raindrops, naturally that the memories will come, the dreams will come. So same thing it happens in your poem, The Rain on the Roof. So thank you everybody. I will send you everything in written form also, and so wish you good time ahead. I hope we will meet soon. So stay at home, stay safe. Thank you.